Welcome to this video of Daily Current Affairs. Today is the 27th of June 2019. This is episode number 334. These are our channels Pinnacle and Frontier IAS. If you have not subscribed to them, then subscribe to the channels. Click on the bell icon. These are our websites ssccglpinnacle.com and baljeetdhaka.com. These are our websites. You can visit them too. Subscribe to the channel so that you never miss an update from us. Now here are the questions of the previous quiz. The first question: when is the International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking observed? This is the first question. Now answer for this question, what is going to be the answer? Answer is June 26th. Next question: which country will host the 2026 Winter Olympics and Paralympics? And answer here is going to be Italy. Italy is going to be the host. First question for today: who won the Red Ink Award for Journalist of the Year 2019? This is the first question, and answer here is going to be Rachna Khera. Let me show you her picture. See, this is Rachna Khera. Okay, Rachna Khera of the Tribune News Service has won Red Ink Award for Journalist of the Year 2019. This award was given for her expose on the functioning of the Unique Identification Authority of India, UIDAI, and its Aadhaar data sachet held in 2018. Investigation conducted by Rachna confirmed that personal data of millions of citizens was at risk of being hacked, traded for a price. Then later, many of the leads provided by her became part of a public interest litigation, which finally led to troublesome and mandatory aspect of Aadhaar being watered down. She's currently working for the Huffington Post. Okay, so that is a picture, and this now that is the information about the first question. We tell you that we have started our SSC CGL Tier 2 Job Assured program. This is a comprehensive day-wise scheduled program, and if you feel you have done well in your Tier 1 and you are going to get a call for Tier 2, you have to appear for your Tier 2, then you cannot afford to miss this course. You will definitely score at least 360 marks out of 400 when you join this program. It's a comprehensive, day-wise, very well scheduled and systematic program. Here are the details. Okay, you can see, if you do not wish to join for English and maths both, then you can join only for maths or only for English. But it is advisable that you join our umbrella programs of SSC CGL online coaching course and hard drive course, because under this you will be given tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 for at least 2 years, 2019 and 2020. SSC CGL tier 2 online test series is also there with videos. SSC CGL tier 2 online test series without videos. All the details of the various courses for tier 2 are given. What is the title of autobiography of Anupam Kher? This is the second question. Answer here is going to be Life Lessons Taught Me Unknowingly. This is my answer. Question number 2. Answer here is B. In my recent videos, I had told you about the autobiography of Baba Ramdev as well. Kindly let me know what was the name in the comment section. Here is a picture related to this question: Lessons Life Taught Me Unknowingly, an autobiography by Anupam Kher. Bollywood actor Anupam Kher is coming out with his autobiography titled Lessons Life Has Taught Me Unknowingly. This book is expected to offer a peep into the life and times of Anupam Kher as an actor and entertainer. The book is being published by Penguin Random House. He is a winner of 2 national awards, 8 Filmfare awards and a BAFTA nomination. Okay, he is also a receiver of the Padma Shri in 2004 and Padma Bhushan 2016 awards. He also has a best-selling book, The Best Thing About You Is You, to his credit. Okay, so that is the information about this question. Okay, recently another actor had written a book called Dopehri, if you remember, and Dopehri was written by Pankaj Kapoor. Another book about which I had covered in my videos recently, The New Delhi Conspiracy by Meenakshi Lekhi. Let's move on to the next question. Here the question is, what is the theme of International Day of Seafarer? That's question number 3. Now answer for this question is going to be, I am on board with gender equality. Answer here is going to be C. C is the right answer. Day of the Seafarer was celebrated throughout the world on 25th of June. The theme for the day, what was the theme for this particular day? It was Get on Board with Gender Equality. The International Maritime Organization is calling on everyone in the maritime world and beyond to get on board with this year's theme of gender equality and declare their support. IMO is headquartered at London. Let me show you a picture. See here, you can see the picture. I am on board with gender equality 2019. Day of the Seafarer, 25th of June. Next question, we are on question number 4. Here the question is, Indian Air Force commemorated 20 years of Kargil War by making a war theater in which city? This is the question, and the answer here is going to be Gwalior. Answer here, question number 4 will be Gwalior. B is the right answer. Okay, so here Indian Air Force has commemorated 20 years of Kargil War by making a theater in Gwalior. Okay, this 20 years of Kargil War, and where did Kargil War take place? On May, and from May to July 1999, by turning Gwalior Air Base, the Gwalior Air Base has been turned into a war theater with a dramatic reenactment of some milestones of 1999 operation, such as Tiger Hill attack. Chief Marshal D.S. Dhanova was the chief guest for this event. Let me show you a picture. See here, you can see the picture. To mark the 20th anniversary of the Kargil Vijay Diwas, a number of celebratory events had been planned by the Indian Army in Delhi and Dras in Jammu and Kashmir, which will take place in the next month. The anniversary celebrations for 2019 will be conducted on a nationwide platform from 25th to 27th of July. Next question about Niti Aayog. Which state is the most unhealthy state in India as per Niti Aayog's health index? That's my question. Question number 5. The most unhealthy state is Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh is my right answer. Uttar Pradesh remains the most unhealthy as per the second edition of Niti Aayog's state health index. Kerala has topped among large states on overall health performance in Niti Aayog's health index, followed by Andhra Pradesh and Maharashtra. In terms of incremental performance, Haryana, Rajasthan and Jharkhand are the top three states who performed well in comparison to the last health index. That was question number 5. So Uttar Pradesh is the most unhealthy state in our country. Here you can see a picture related to this. See very clearly, it is written here, Healthy States Progressive India. Next question. The question here is, who inaugurated the famous Ambu Bachi Mela in Guwahati? This is the question. Question number 6. It was inaugurated by Sarbanand Sonwal. Okay, Sonwal. This is Assam's largest religious congregation. The Ambu Bachi Mela at Kamkhya Temple. It is on top of Neelachal Hills. It was inaugurated by Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonwal. This fair is also known as Mahakumbh of the East, as it attracts millions of devotees from all over the world. The 4-day annual Mela, it will be held from 22nd June to 25th of June, during which the temple door of the Kamkhya remains closed. Okay, and it is believed that the presiding goddess of the temple during these 4 days goes through her menstrual cycle, which is an annual phenomena. This is question number 6. And here you can see a picture related to this. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Who has been appointed as the next Director General of Indian Coast Guard? This is question number 7. And answer here for question number 7 is C. Krishna Swami Natarajan. Krishna Swami Natarajan has been appointed as the next Director General of Indian Coast Guard and would be replacing incumbent Rajendra Singh, who is retiring after 3.5 years of illustrious command. Additional Director General K. Natarajan has held various important command and staff appointments, both afloat and ashore. He joined the Coast Guard on June 18, 1984. Let's take a look at his picture. See, this is his picture. Now we are on question number 8. In question number 8, what have we been asked? Let's take a look at the question. World Bank approved a $147 million loan agreement for urban services to which state? This is question number 8. answer here is going to be Jharkhand. Jharkhand is going to be my right answer B. The World Bank has approved a $147 million loan agreement to provide basic urban services to the people of Jharkhand. Their aim is to improve the management capacity of the urban local bodies in the state. They focus on improving the municipal sector's capacity to provide basic urban services. Their main aim is to strengthen the capacity of the Jharkhand Urban Infrastructure Development Company. Government of India, urbanization and economic growth are interlinked, and a comprehensive roadmap for municipal reforms through the Amrut scheme. Now here we have talked about Jharkhand. Let me show you Jharkhand in a map. See, this is the state of Jharkhand. It was made out of Bihar. Jharkhand, what is the capital? Ranchi. Total 24 districts. Governor is Draupadi Murmu. Chief Minister here is Raghubar Das. Legislature is unicameral with 81 seats, Lok Sabha 14 seats, Rajya Sabha 6 seats. The national parks located here are Betla National Park, Hazaribagh National Park and Rajdevra National Park. Next question, question number 9. Recently in my videos I told you that Mauritania is going to have a new president. Presidential elections are going to be conducted there, okay? So who is the new president there? Answer here is Mohammed Ould Ghozani. Mohammed Ould Ghozani, that's my answer. My answer here is going to be D. So new president of Mauritania is going to be Mohammed Ould Ghozani. Mauritania, it's a country in Northwest Africa. It conducted elections. A former general and defense minister, Mohammed Ould Ghozani of the Union of the Republic Party, won the presidential elections. And how many votes did he secure? He secured 52% votes. Okay, it's a country in Northwest Africa and it went to polls for the first time since the African nation gained independence from France nearly 60 years ago. So in 60 years, first time voting was done in this country. Let's take a look at a picture of the new president. He is the new president. Next question, which Indian film has won the Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award at the Shanghai International Film Festival? This is question number 10. And for question number 10, my answer here is going to be B. B is the right answer. Question number 10, B. Malayalam film Vegiril Marangal, okay, which means Trees Under the Sun, directed by Dr. Biju, has won the Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award at the 22nd Shanghai International Film Festival. It became the first Indian film to win a major award at the festival. Vegiril Marangal focuses on a Dalit family from Kerala, which loses everything in a major flood. They migrate to Himachal in search of livelihood at an apple orchard. Okay, let me show you a picture. See here, you can see the picture. Now, these were the 10 questions for today. Let me take you to the summary keywords. Here are the summary keywords. Red Ink Award for Journalist of the Year 2019. Who won it? Rachna Kheria won this award. Okay, next. Autobiography of Anupam Kher, Lessons Life Taught Me Unknowingly. International Day of the Seafarer, what is the theme? I am on board with gender equality, and this was on 25th of June. IAF, 20 years of Kargil War, okay? These are the keywords. Indian Air Force has commemorated 20 years of Kargil War by making a war theater in Gwalior. Most unhealthy state is UP, according to Niti Aayog's Health Index. Ambu Bachi Mela held in Guwahati and Sarbanand Sonowal, he inaugurated the Mela. New Director General of Indian Coast Guard is Krishna Swami Natarajan. Then next you see here is World Bank and $147 million loan. That is what you see here. Okay. Now for this, what is the information about these two keywords? The information is that World Bank has approved a $147 million loan agreement for urban services to Jharkhand. New president of Mauritania is Mohammed Ould Ghozani. Outstanding Artistic Achievement Award, okay, went to a movie called Vegiril Marangal at the Shanghai International Film Festival. These were the summary keywords, and here we are on the quiz for the day. The first question here that you see is, what is the title of the autobiography of Anupam Kher? That's the first question. who has been appointed as the next Director General of Indian Coast Guard? This is question number 2. I want you to answer both these questions in the comment section. Okay, I want you to answer both these questions in the comment section. And in my recent videos, I had told you about the highest meteorological station being set up in the world. So where has it been set up? I want you to answer that as well. Answer these questions in the comment section. If you have liked the video, click on the like button. As much as possible, share the video and subscribe to the channel. And definitely, if you are hopeful and feel positive that you will be able to get a call for SSC CGL Tier 2, then do not forget to join our Job Assure program, because we design courses exclusively in English medium for those who want to have them exclusively in English. All the best. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.